Good morning, Battlefield kids, and happy Sunday. I hope you guys are doing well. I want to go ahead and sing another song just like we did last week. Even though we can't be together, I know it's just a good time to get up and praise the Lord through music. So wherever you are, if you're able, go ahead and stand up and let's sing along to this next song.
I'm gonna
That was awesome, guys. Great singing. I hope you've been enjoying us having these songs in the mix with our lessons. It gets us up, moving around, and worshiping the Lord with music, which I just love to do. Well, here we are. We are into week 2 of this very last unit of the Old Testament. Today, we're going to be in the book of Nehemiah. But before we go there, let's go ahead and review our unit verse one more time. A couple of you have actually already gotten me your videos with your memorized verse, so keep up the good work. But if you'll remember, our unit verse is in the book of 1 Peter. It's in chapter 5 and it's verse 10. And again, we find 1 Peter right after the book of James in the New Testament and right before 2 Peter. Let's go ahead and read it together. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10. So again, you still have a couple weeks to get this verse to me. Video messages are fine, or if you're here on Sunday morning, just find me. I'm in the sanctuary with you guys, and you can certainly recite the verse to me then. And again, keep up the good work, and nice job to those of you that have already had it memorized. So again, we are headed into the book of Nehemiah in the Old Testament. We're actually going to split Nehemiah up into 2 Sundays. So today, we will focus on chapters 1-6, and then next week, we will finish out the book. And you can find Nehemiah between the books of Ezra and Esther. So take a minute, go ahead and flip there. If you have younger brothers and sisters and they need help, help them find the book too. Again, Old Testament, it's between Ezra and Esther. We're in the book of Nehemiah today. I'll give you a minute. All right. So again, like I said, we're splitting Nehemiah into 2 Sundays. So here's the first part of the book of Nehemiah that we're going to talk about. And some of the story may sound a little familiar to you. If you'll remember, we talked a while back, and it's been a part of all of our lessons. We had God's people stuck in captivity in Babylon for 70 years. And if you'll remember, we learned that during the time that King Cyrus was the king of Persia, he let the captives go home. He let them finally leave Babylon, and they were out of the 70 years of captivity that they had been in. You may also remember that some of God's people didn't leave. They didn't go back home. They actually stayed there. Well, one of those people was Nehemiah. Nehemiah stayed and he worked for the king of Persia for a while. One day, Nehemiah ran into some men that had come from Judah, from his homeland. They had come back, and Nehemiah was curious, so he asked them how things were going there. Unfortunately, the men had bad news. Things weren't going well. They told Nehemiah that the people were in trouble, the walls around Jerusalem were broken down, and the gates had been burned down. This made Nehemiah sad, and he cried. It actually says in chapter 1 of the book of Nehemiah, verse 4, "And it came to pass, when I heard these words, that I sat down and wept and mourned and fasted and prayed before the God of heaven." Nehemiah cried and he fasted. He was sad. He prayed to God. His homeland was under fire, and this devastated Nehemiah. I think it would devastate you too. I know I'd be very upset if where I lived was burning down and things were being broken down. So that's how Nehemiah felt at this time, but he cried out to God. The king actually noticed that something was wrong with Nehemiah, and Nehemiah got scared because you weren't supposed to be sad in front of the king. So this scared Nehemiah a little bit, but the king asked Nehemiah what was wrong. So Nehemiah told him, he said, "The city where my ancestors are from is in trouble, and the gates of the city have been burned down." Do you know what the king did? He actually sent Nehemiah home. He told him to go home, to see what was happening, to take care of his city where his ancestors were from. Nehemiah got there and he inspected the walls and he led the people there to start rebuilding. He told them they needed to rebuild what had been destroyed. All around the city, people worked side by side, shoulder to shoulder, they worked together to help get the wall rebuilt. Soon the wall was half as tall as it had been. Fortunately, like with a lot of things, not everyone was happy that the wall was being built. There were some men who were angry. God's people kept working on the walls, but their enemies made a plan to attack them. We see that a lot as we've studied the Old Testament, that God's people are often under attack by the enemies, but just like the other stories we've seen, things will work out in the end for God's people. God's people prayed. They had men who would guard the walls all day and night. They still felt discouraged, though. I'm sure you've had times where even when you pray and you feel like you're doing everything right, you might feel a little discouraged. That's how the people were feeling that Nehemiah was with. Nehemiah reminded them, though, that God was with them. He told them, "Do not be afraid." We've talked about that. We hear that a lot in the Bible. So Nehemiah was reminding them, "Do not be afraid. God is great and powerful. He is with us." Then Nehemiah told the people to be ready. He said, "If the enemies attack, God will fight for them because God is always there for us." The enemies could threaten God's people, but they could not make them stop building. We can feel threatened. We can feel like we're being attacked. But if we continue to work towards what God wants us to do and His will and His way, He's going to be with us. He's going to protect us. Their enemies were not in charge of rebuilding the wall. We know that. God was. God was in charge, and God was using Nehemiah to encourage them. God's people went back to work. They still stayed on guard, and they always were ready to protect the wall if their enemies attacked. Nehemiah was a wise and good leader for God's people. In 52 days, the wall was complete. That's pretty amazing. We've talked before. I mean, they're not dealing with people here who have dump trucks and electricity and all that. They built a wall in 52 days by hand. That's pretty amazing work if you think about it. The gates were repaired and the wall was restored. When Jerusalem's enemies heard the news that the wall had been restored, they actually were afraid. I'll actually read you. It says in Nehemiah chapter 6, verses 15 through 16, it says, "So the wall was finished in 52 days. And it came to pass that when all our enemies heard thereof, and all the heathen that were about us saw these things, they were much cast down in their own eyes, for they perceived that this work was wrought of our God." It's telling us that they were afraid because they knew that God was with His people. He had proven through the work that His people did and the encouragement that Nehemiah had given them that He was with them through all of this, even when their enemies surrounded them. And we can feel that too. We can know that if we are doing what God is asking us to do and we are being faithful and obedient to Him, He's going to be with us all the time, even in scary situations, which we may face on a daily basis. So just remember that in everything that you do, that God is with you and He is in control of everything. I hope you guys have a great Sunday. I hope you've been enjoying the lessons. I pray that we're back together in person very soon, but I'm going to go ahead and close us in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank You for the ability to gather virtually during these times, Lord. We thank You for each and every family that's watching today, and I ask that You just put Your hand of protection on each of them and just remind them that in everything they do, You are in control and You will protect them. Lord, I just ask that You bless the remainder of this day for everyone watching. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.